There's not a rapper out here that got a fucking record comparable to that. Everything he pulled off in that song, just rap-wise, reach-wise, mood-wise, the delivery of it, the emotion conveyed in this motherfucker, man, what this song means, the impact, the reach. No rapper out here has a fucking song comparable to that. The numbers behind the goddamn song, even though numbers is last on my list as far as why Eminem is the goddamn GOAT, man. Bruh. But he's animated. He's comical. No, fuck that. Fuck that.
When you spoke of people who meant the most to you, you left me off your list. Fuck you, hip hop. I'm leaving you. My life sentence is served, bitch.
Oh, mine is blown.
I was like, damn.
Mine is blown. He just told you, bro. Fuck hip hop, dog.
Hey, when my mother still tries to show me some old fake pictures of a fictitious little sister who never existed, and this is why part of my life so twisted.
Ooh, and that's that fucking disease that his mother had. She sat there and lied to him and told him that he had a baby sister that fell out of a fucking window. And continuing the recovery album review, but doing that No Love. No Love 2.0. And speaking of 2.0, I have to go back real quick and see who I gave the dub to. All right, y'all probably gonna be pissed because of what I said in this video, man. But look, it is what it is, man. It is what it is. I realize who Eminem is, man. But on No Love, I probably picked the wrong song to go to first because I got Eminem 0-1 verses so far. All right, the first go through was Lil Wayne. So let's do it.
To get mixtapes. And somewhere through there, I heard Marshall and I was like, is that a white boy? That sounds like a white boy. Like, you know, it wasn't just the accent and the style, it was the content. I was like, the mushrooms, yeah. the trippy, the white boy shit. And then, yeah, I just started digging through and...
That's hard.
Trying to find more, you know?
Was it Any Man?
Huh?
Was it that song? Any Man That Jump In Front Of A Minivan?
Any Man That Could Jump In Front Of A Minivan with 20 grand, a bottle of pain pills, and some mini things is fucking crazy.
Let's get it. Part two. Hold on. What up, Night Nation? It's your boy, Stevie Knight. About to get on one of these things, you feel me? What's good with my Patreon family? What's cracking with y'all, man? Yeah, we're doing this part two. Pretty much, I'm going to try to provide the best case out there that Eminem is the GOAT, man. Like, objectively, bro. I'm going to show y'all that Eminem has more tools in the toolbox than anybody, bro. And it's not even close. Got a drink, too, so you know what type of video it's about to be. Not even close. You know why it's not close? Because, you know what? I'm not going to do no summary, man. I'm not going to do no summary. We're going to dive right in this bitch, man. Got the shirt on. I chose this one, too, because, like, if you come out this motherfucker still, at least, like, hating on Eminem, if this shit don't even make you think twice about what your stance on him, unless you identify as a hater, then this definitely applies to you because you a hoe. This is not even what this shirt is meant about. This is actually, like, saying hoes are headaches, like, you know, hoes as in women, bitches, a particular type of bitch that, a particular type of woman that provides a headache for a man. That's what this shirt's about. But we're going to make it a whole double in meaning that if you out here and you just a hater, you a hoe, you are a headache, bro. Real shit. And, bro, like, I just dropped the fucking reaction to the Cordae remix. You know, Eminem showed up, did his thing, bro. And I recorded it, but I dropped it as a live. So I can see the live comments, bro. And like the hate, like, bro, that just puts more battery in my pack to do shit like this, bro, because I'm all for it. Even though, like, I know it's a pointless feat, like the hate is not going to go anywhere because hate is not objective. Hate is hate. Like, something wrong with that motherfucker. But I'm a warrior at this point, bro. You're not about to be out here just talking all this nonsensical bullshit. Like, if you can make it make sense, I'm here to entertain whatever you can, you know, provide in regards to, like, actual criticism for Eminem that does not display him as the GOAT or, you know, as elite as he is. If you out here talking on some bullshit or some biased shit. I'm not trying to hear that. We need to be on some 2 plus 2 equal 4 shit. Not no 2 plus 2 equal whatever the fuck I like. You know what I mean? And, bruh, it was so much fucking hate in the comments, man. I should have had my mods in there to kick all that shit out, bruh. Because that's just unnecessary, man. Like, at the big picture of this, to me, it's like, bruh, as talented as Eminem is and as long as he's been doing it, he gets the most hate. The most hate, racism aside. Like, put that shit over there. Racism, crazy-ass stands. Put that shit over there, man. It's just, motherfuckers just come up with any goddamn thing to hate on this motherfucker for, bro. You know what I mean? Like, goddamn, chillax. It ain't that goddamn deep. It's like it's better off if Eminem just stopped rapping because y'all gonna goddamn go through all this shit and, bro, this shit is, like, shut the fuck up, bro. You know what I mean? I'm irritated at this point, bro, because I know what the fuck it is. I know what the fuck it is with Eminem, bro. And he's not even my guy. Not my favorite rapper, bro. And it may seem like I'm on some Stan shit. I'm not no fucking Stan. Like, I don't live, breathe shit, like, praise Eminem. Like, if he do some fucked up shit, I'm gonna call him out on his fucked up shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, he's not my favorite rapper, but he's put too much in this game to be disrespected like that, bro. And I know what the fuck he's done. And when you come out here with these fucking, these useless claims, these, all this bullshit, like, I'm on some, bruh, right is right, wrong is wrong. What motherfuckers do and how they be talking is wrong. Even though he has a lot more praise than anything, but Eminem gets more hate than anybody. And with my platform, as much as he's done for me, as much as I know about what the fuck it is, as much as he's done for this fucking game, I'm not about to sit back and just let that goddamn happen, bro. Fuck that, because it's stupid. It's stupid, bro. Like, get the fuck out of here, man. And I got a voice in this shit, and we're going to make it happen. And to diffuse that, defeat all that, deflect all that, I'm going to provide you objective, tangible reasons why this motherfucker is the GOAT. He has more in his toolbox than anybody. Whether you like it or not, then the world does not revolve around you. The world does not revolve around me. Do I personally like how a lot of Eminem shit sounds? No, as far as song choice, beat selection and all that, it ain't about that. It's about what the fuck he done to this game. Does he have shit that I like? Hell yeah. Does he have shit these people like? Hell yeah, bro. And that's what it is, bro. Your reach, your influence, your impact on hip-hop, bro. That's what the fuck it is. At least for me, man. And, all right. We're going to shift gears, though. Last video, I highlighted three things to start it off. I mean, I started with bangers. You know, bangers is kind of subjective, too. Like everybody's definition of banger is different, bro. I gave y'all what bangers was for me. When I meant bangers, it's not like, you know, crazy bar-heavy songs or... It's just about bangers, bro. Like, bangers. Like, if you turn this shit on, regardless who the fuck you are, if you don't like how that shit sounds, then you're an alien. And then I gave y'all a bunch. I gave y'all Chloroseptic. I gave y'all Medicine Man. I gave y'all Bang. I gave y'all... And I gave y'all Best Friend. And Best Friend, like I said, is arguably, to me, it's arguably Eminem's best verse. Not meaning like his most bar heavy goddamn song. He got a lot more songs that got more bars in it than Best Friend. But Best Friend, I think, is a good representation of as much of what Eminem can provide in one song, man. Got the bars, got the cadence, got double timing, got verse structure, got internal, external rhyme schemes, all that, you know, verse preparation, technical ability, man. But it's the emotion from the song, bro, because like everything he's saying in there comes from a place. It ain't like he's out here talking his shit because he's talking his shit. It all comes from a place. Like he gets a fucking battery pack in his ass to respond to criticism, respond to hate, respond to motherfuckers doubting him. And then he goes on a whole tangent about the impact Proof has on him, bro. Like the whole song, that's where it's coming from. But he delivers it in bars and lyricism and cadence. Just the emotion conveyed through that. I mean, it encompasses everything. That's why I think that's Eminem's best verse to me. It gives you a feeling. You get a feeling from hearing that verse, but then he does everything he does with it, you know, technically. All right. Right, the way I described the Best Friend, I summed it up. Put this out there. He can do all that in one fucking song. Find another fucking rapper that can do all that in one fucking song. All right, give me lyrics, give me bars, all that shit, bro. Hey, bars, lyrics are the prerequisite to even be considered on this list of GOATs. You have to have bars. But what else can you do on top of bars? And Eminem did a lot more on top of bars in this goddamn song. So with Best Friend, find me another goddamn artist as a song comparable to that. that has the reach and the impact that fucking song has, right? But you have to fucking, you have to know the song enough to even find something comparable. Just don't be shooting from the hip, oh, this is my favorite song from this artist, and even I haven't heard Best Friend, but I bet this song fucks with Best Friend. No, it ain't about that. Go through Best Friend, break it down, if you're able to break shit down, and then let me know. If you can't break shit down, fuck out of here. Cadence, bro. Cadence. I didn't highlight Eminem enough in what he does cadence wise. Though I started from the beginning of Stay Wide Away. Just to give y'all a little taste, bro. Find me another tool in the toolbox, cadence. Find me another song from an artist that we consider one of these goats, one of the best rappers out here, that has cadence on par or better than what Eminem does in this song right now. I'm about to let y'all hear some more of that goddamn song right now. Cause I didn't show them the right part. So let's do this again.
Wait, now I use power tools. How about now? Are you in the shower? Scour you for 6 hours to outage your power outlet. How did you figure out I was down in your basement? Now you must have just heard the sound of my stomach growling from down there. Power, there's no one fouler. Round you, that's how they found you. Face down in the tub, I ground you with piles of downers around you. Such nostalgia and power, such prowess. Look how you cower. Jump out on you now like I was a Jawa from fucking Star Wars. Jabba the Hutt, bitty baba, bitty baba. It's time to die. What's a naive? Even bother to scream, it don't even matter. Amazing when grazing skin with these razor blades, he waves at ya. Not your everyday Damien, bathe me in holy water. Nothing like Sunderstand, so please understand there's no gun in hand. Where's the thrill in the hunt? There's no fun in that. Here I come with axe. Once I act like Lumberjack when I'm hacking them up with that. What was that? Dial 911, someone's coming in from the soon back. Soon as my flow starts.
Find me a song that sounds like that. Audibly, fuck what he's talking about. Even though you have to consider what he's talking about when he pulls off that cadence. But, bruh, the cadence that he pulled off on that shit is ridiculous. Ridiculous. So find me something comparable to that from one of these goats out here. Not even comparable. No, fuck that. We're talking about tools in the toolbox. Who's better? Find me cadence that sounds better than that from one of y'all's goats. One of y'all's top 5, top 10, top 15. Find me that. All right? And if he gives you cadence, what is he talking about? What is he talking about? Eminem pulled that cadence off with the most fictitious murderers. He wrote a fucking psycho killer story and pulled that cadence off with it. How difficult is that to do? And then just gave you Best Friend and all that. All right, but I can do this all day. But all right, this video getting long already. I'm just giving y'all a summary of what the fuck took place. So we did hard songs, bangers, cadence, and then we just did monster records, anthems. And I ended the video on this. To me, this song is enough to put every other fucking rapper there is out there on this little goat list that y'all got to sleep. No rapper has a record comparable to everything this song is, what it represents, what it does, and how it sounds, bro. When you turn this shit on, from the beat, it's a mood. But remember what the fuck took place during this song.
So like collapse, I'm spilling these rats long as you feel them. To the day that I drop, you'll never say that I'm not killing them. Cause when I am not, then I'ma stop pinning them. And I am not hip-hop, and I'm just not Eminem. Subliminal thoughts when I'ma stop sending them. Women are caught in webs, spin them in heart venom. Adrenaline shots, the penicillin could not get the illness.
The flow on this song is so unorthodox, so complex. He's rhyming when you're not supposed to rhyme, where you're not expecting a sound to rhyme. That is so advanced. That's so complex. And this song is what it is, bro. They played this song before football games. They played this song to get motherfuckers juiced up. Bro, this song is like, somebody gave me the stat. It's like the most selling record that's not a single from a hip-hop artist. This wasn't even a fucking single. And he did so much. And this was early on in Eminem's career, before the bars and all that shit, bro. This song is so complex. The message behind this fucking song, the vibe behind this song, the soul, the swag behind this song, the shit that people criticize Eminem for. He has no soul. He has no swag. He blah 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 blah. Oh, fuck that, bro. If you fucking hear this shit and you don't bop to it, that means you ain't got what the fuck these people be talking about, bro. Cadence alone, flow alone, rhyme scheme alone, find me a rapper that can pull that shit off. But then talk about what he's talking about, why he's pulling that shit off. Then have the reach with this song, bro. This is a fucking a monster record. It has everything. There's not a rapper out here that has a single comparable to this. It ain't. It ain't, bro. It's not. It's not. It's not. And if there is, debate me. Debate me. Another tool in Eminem's toolbox. Fucking monster record that just shows you how the fuck to do this hip-hop shit. 5 million of pop listeners, you're coming with me, feel it or not, you're gonna fear it like I showed you. The spirit of God lives in us. You hear it a lot, lyrics the shock. Is it a miracle or am I just product of pop? Listen up, the sizzle, my whistle, this is the plot. Listen up, you pistols for God, slizzle does not give a fuck. Let the whole shit ride this time. Jim, my leg, give out, can't shut my mouth. Jim, the smoke clears out, and my high, I'm gonna rip this shit, till my bone pull out. Music is like magic. There's a certain feeling you get when you reel and you speak, and people are feeling your shit. This is your moment, and every single minute you spend trying to hold on to it, because you may never get it again. Bruh, do you hear how he did that shit? And then listen, what the fuck he's saying?
Music is like magic. There's a certain feeling you keep when you reel and you speak, and people are feeling your shit. This is your moment, and every single minute you spend trying to hold on to it, because you may never get it again. So while you're in it, try to get as much shit as you can. And when your run is over, just admit when it's in its end. Because I'm at the end of my wits with half the shit that gets in.
Bruh, he's a fucking hip-hop soldier out this motherfucker, dog. I'm sitting here breaking the goddamn song down, bruh. But if you don't get it, you don't get it. It ain't for you to get got, dog. But ain't there's nobody out here that got a record like this.
You may never get it again, so while you're in it, try to get as much shit as you can. And when your run is over, just admit when it's in its end. Because I'm at the end of my wits with half the shit that gets in. I got a list. Here's the order of my list that it's in. It goes Reggie, Jay-Z, Tupac, and Biggie, Andre from Outkast, Jay, Corrupt, Nas, and Thimmy.
Saying what he's saying. He ain't gotta do that. He ain't gotta do that. Tupac and Big Me.
It's the order of my list that it's in. It goes Reggie, Jay-Z, Tupac, and Biggie, Andre from Outkast, Jada, Corrupt, Nas, and Thimmy. But in this industry, I'm the cause of a lot of envy. So when I'm not put on this list, the shit does not offend me. That's why you see me walk around.
And then I'm sitting here defending them and shit. That's why if you don't put me on this list, this shit does not offend me. Because you love hip-hop, bruh.
So when I'm not put on this list, the shit does not offend me. That's why you see me walk around like nothing's bothering me. Even though half your people got a fucking problem with me. You hate it, but you more respect you got to give me. The press is wet dream like Bob and your Whitney. They hit me.
Till the roof comes off, till the lights go out.
All right, I still gonna play the whole thing. I can't. I'm already at probably like 20 minutes now. It's gonna be a long ass video, bro. No, there's not a rapper out here that got a fucking record comparable to that. Everything he pulled off in this song, just rap wise, reach wise, mood wise, the delivery of it, the emotion conveyed in this motherfucker, man. What this song means, the impact, the reach. No rapper out here has a fucking song comparable to that. The numbers behind the goddamn song, even though numbers is last on my list as far as why Eminem is the goddamn GOAT, man. Bruh. But he's animated. He's comical. No, fuck that. Fuck that, bruh. Fuck that. That shit is insulting. More monster records.
Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes gravity, he choke, he's so mad.
Do I need to explain? I feel like I need to explain for the motherfuckers who don't get it. Monster record, numbers-wise, reach-wise, the movie, the damn song highlights what took place in the fucking movie, man. So it's just another fucking tool in this toolbox. Can you put some Paramount shit in fucking audio format, man? Right? Find me another rapper doing it like that. With the amount of appeal and reach and influence that this fucking song has. They play this shit. This song is soundtrack. It is a soundtrack. But this song is played for other soundtracks. To get motherfuckers ready. To get motherfuckers going, bruh. That's what I'm talking about here. Come on, man. What are other rappers at that's doing that shit? Tool in the toolbox, man. Monster record and just records that get motherfuckers going, man. It's a go-to, bro. What else? He got Monster Records all day. I can go all fucking day, bro. I'm not playing with y'all. I'm not playing with y'all, bro.
Since birth, I've been cursed with this curse to just curse and just blur, this berserk and bizarre shit that works and it sells and it helps in itself to relieve all this tension, this bitch and these sentences getting this stress that's been eating me recently off of this chest and I rest again peacefully.
Impact. Monster record. But in this case, it's a monster record for a whole nother fucking reason. We have Till I Collapse, get you fucking going, get you going, bro. Lose Yourself, get you going. This one, he is being transparent, being vulnerable with his audience, letting motherfuckers know where he is, how he sees shit, letting you know where he stands, right? That's a tool in his toolbox, right? But a lot of artists do that. They're transparent. I would argue there's no other fucking rapper out here that's putting a heart on their sleeve as much as Eminem has. But it's delivery. It's the way he is executing this shit, bro. The way he's rapping is so advanced. The flow in this shit is so advanced. It's not just flow. It's not just MC shit. It's the soul in this song. Eminem ain't got no soul. He raps the same way all the goddamn time. He's comical. He's animated. Ain't nothing comical or animated about this shit at all. I am whatever you say I am. If I wasn't, then why would I say I am? Come on, bro. He's done with y'all shit, but he's rapping it like this.
Cursed, it just cursed and just blurred, just berserk. And bizarre shit that works and it sells and it helps in itself to relieve all this tension, this bitch and these sentences getting this stress that's been eating me recently off of this chest and I rest to get peacefully.
But at least have the decency in you to leave me alone when you freaks see me out in the streets. When I'm eating or feeding my daughter to not come and speak to me. I don't know you and no, I don't owe you a motherfucking thing. I'm not Mr. NSYNC, I'm not with your friends. Think I'm not Mr. Friendly, I can't be great. And you tip me, my tank is on empty.
No patience is in me,
and if in you offend me, I'm lifting you 10 feet. In the air, I don't care who was there, who saw me, just draw you, or call you a lawyer, fire you a lawsuit. I smile in the courtroom and buy you a war. I'm tired of all you. I don't mean to be mean, but that's me I can be, it's just me.
Bruh, come on, man.
I am whatever you say I am. If I wasn't, then why would I say I am? In the paper, the news.
He did what he did, how he did it, and said what he said, bruh. Motherfuckers talking like he ain't. Come on, bro. And this is from the guy. This is from Marshall Mathers LP, bro. Rapping like that. Early on in Eminem's career. Second album, dog. Second album. That advanced way ahead of his time. Way ahead of his league, bro. I would argue there's not a rapper out here that was that new into their career. That wet behind the ears into that career that would even think to attack a song like that, bro. That shit was so advanced, complex rhyme schemes, that all galore, bro. And it is a fucking banger. This is a monument of Eminem's career, man. You have to include this goddamn song if you were describing Eminem, like in his biography, whatever the fuck, bro. Ain't no rapper out here that can pull that shit off. None. It's not. It's levels, bro. It ain't about bars. It's about reach, impact, influence. And then it sounded the way he sounded. All right. Next up, Monster Records. I'm sitting here like, I'm not even meaning to like focused on what he's doing so much lyrically. I'm trying to find like monster records, regardless of what the fuck he's talking about. It's a monster record. But with Eminem, it will be a monster record, but he's rapping better than everybody, dog. So monster records, right? Well, fuck how you feel about this goddamn song. Monster goddamn record. But if you feel the type of way about this song, that means you're just not informed. You're not informed. You don't know enough about Eminem to feel the way you fucking feel about this goddamn record, bro. Tell me if you hear that beat, it don't put you somewhere. You tell me, regardless who the fuck you are, if you fuck with Eminem or not, you tell me if you hear that beat, you're not prepared to fucking sing this hook. Right? You telling me that? Regardless how you feel about this shit, you telling me that? If you are telling me that you don't fuck with this record, you're a liar.
Where's my snare?
This is why Eminem is the GOAT, bruh. This is why Eminem is the GOAT, dog.
There you go. Yeah.
Have you ever been hated or discriminated against? I have. I've been protested and demonstrated against. Picket signs for my wicked rhymes. Look at the times. Sick is the mind of the... keep this behind. All this commotion, emotions run deep as oceans exploding. Tempers flaring from parents. Just blow them off and keep going. Not taking nothing from no one. Give them hell long as I'm breathing. Keep kicking ass in the morning and taking names in the evening.
And this is my
with
thing.
The taste of sour.
It's one thing to just try to convey a feeling in a song. Where you are, being transparent, being vulnerable. It's one thing just to be open with your audience. Right? Delivery, I would argue, don't even matter as much if you're just being open and transparent with your audience, man. Right? He could just do this shit simplistically, but to deliver it in such a rap way, man. Like, regardless of what the fuck he's talking about, what the fuck is he attacking, what tool he's gonna fucking showcase in his toolbox, this one he's being transparent, I'm still gonna attack that shit in a better rap way than anybody else. That's another tool in his toolbox. That's two in one, which is a whole another fucking tool, bro. Right? Main criticism behind this song. This is what I feel like. This is the song that everybody goes to, the haters or the naysayers or the ill-informed. All he does right about killing his mama and killing his wife and shit like that, right? When motherfuckers say shit like that, it just lets me know that they don't know nothing about nothing. Because I guarantee, bro, if you experienced what he experienced as a child with a relationship with his mother, if you knew, and he says it in this goddamn song, but motherfuckers ain't get in that far, and they probably didn't even... bothered to fucking research what was it? Mick. I can't even say the fucking word. But his mother suffered from a condition, which directly attributed to the child abuse that he was subjected to. Like, mother abused the fuck out of him when he was a child. Psychological abuse, emotional abuse, making him see the world a certain way. You know what I mean? Munchausen disease, whatever, where mother made Eminem feel like he was sick the whole time. Like, she would, like, give him stuff to make him stay sick, right? On top of that, on other shit, like, his mom made him think that he had a sister that they threw out the fucking window when he was, like, 3 or 4 years. Like, and, I mean, bro, all I'm trying to say is that he ain't just some crazy fucking white boy out here just talking crazy about his mama, man. You knew what the fuck he went through and you were able to put yourself in his shoes. You would not be out here just, you would not be out here just loving your mom. You wouldn't, bro. You wouldn't. But that's what this song, with the third verse, that's what this third verse of the song is about, the mother. The first two verses of the song ain't got shit to do with his mother. He just talking about being persecuted as Eminem, talking this shit, man. But a monster record at the end of the day.
Vinegar in their mouth, see they can trigger me. But they'll never figure me out. Look at me now. I bet you're probably sick of me now. Ain't you, mama? I'ma make you look so ridiculous now. I'm sorry, mama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. But tonight, I'm cleaning out my closet.
And the hook is fire. The hook is fire. I'm cleaning out my closet. I'm airing all this shit out for my audience to know, for them to know everything, which is gonna create more hooks in the audience. They're going to feel like they know Eminem, man. Tool in his fucking toolbox, bruh. Be vulnerable. Let everybody fucking know, but then do it in a rap way. Anyway. He got a lot more monster records than that, but I won't go into so much detail with them just because of time. Even though time doesn't really matter. I may have to split this video into two, man, but y'all get my point, bruh. Like, motherfucker, y'all not fucking with him, bro. Y'all not fucking with him, man.
If you're trying to get out, just follow me. I'll get you.
You can try and read my lyrics off of this paper before I lay them, but you won't take this thing out these words before I say them. Cause ain't no way I'm gonna let you stop me from causing mayhem. When I say I'm gonna do something, I do it. I don't give a damn what you think. I'm doing this for me. So fuck the world, feed it beans. It's gassed up. Everything's just stopping me.
All right, bruh. Monster record. With the message. This record had a lot of fucking effect on its listeners, man. Regardless if they fucking hip-hop heads or not. It's people out here that not even hip-hop fans, but are a fan of Eminem because of the message he conveyed to them, man. I'm not afraid, bro. Like, monster record. But he's still giving you bars. Bars, motherfucker. That's the difference. That ain't even a difference. The difference is rappers out here ain't got records like this. They got records like this. And this whole fucking past 20 minutes has only been one tool in Eminem's toolbox. I have incorporated other tools along the way because he just does so much within his records. Like, he displays more than one tool during songs. But this was meant to just show, hey, monster records. But even with this monster records, he's still showcasing, you know, lyrical ability, still showcasing transparency, still showcasing the connection, still showcasing swag, still showcasing all this other shit people be trying to take away from him. There hasn't been one track yet that I have, you know, played here that showcases him as the "Hi, my name is" comical animated rapper, man. All right, that's enough of the monster records. I'm gonna be here all day. Bro, I got a whole list of monster records here, but we're gonna stop right there because of time. All right, monster records. Next up, something I need to revert back to that I glossed over in the first video. I did not talk about enough of this tool, man. Features, bro. Big ass tool in this toolbox. Gonna read off a few names. I got a whole list, bro. And before I say this list, Eminem has there's not a record Eminem has been featured on with another artist that he just clearly took an L, like majority wise, total consensus. There's never been a record that Eminem just got washed, right? Stands aside, like, stands are never gonna like see Eminem in defeat, right? But you're not gonna wash Eminem. This is just lyrical ability. Him looking at every feature as a tournament. He just said that shit. Every fucking feature I'm on is a tournament. You gotta prove to me that you better, bro. Right? He's never clearly took an L. The features that I have done reactions to that I'm aware of that I feel like Eminem got beat for me personally are No Love with Lil Wayne and Calm Down with Busta Rhymes. With that being said, though, I can understand why someone would have picked Eminem's verse over Lil Wayne. I'm not even gonna say that. I'm giving Eminem fucking leeway. Like, what it is, what it is. I feel like Eminem lost on No Love, and I feel like Eminem lost to Busta Rhymes on Calm Down, right? But with that, let's do this. Where the fuck is the goddamn list at? Hold on, cuz. All right, here we go. Hold on, wait a minute. I'm gonna play a little bit of one song. I can't play the whole goddamn song because YouTube will definitely block this fucking video because they blocked it the first time I did a reaction to it. But I mean, just me playing this song, you know, says it all. So I'm a plex. I don't want to get blocked. Bruh, Jay-Z lost that. Jay-Z said he lost that. And then I'm talking about Jay-Z here. Jay-Z is, you know, consensus-wise, a lot of people's top five dead or alive, bruh. A lot of people's GOAT. And the only argument that I've heard in Eminem and Jay-Z's favor is that Jay-Z was able to describe a New York perspective, how it is in the streets and shit. And people that, you know, relate to that, people that relate to his verse feel like Jay-Z won because they relate to it. But that's subjective. That doesn't matter, right? That doesn't matter. That's irrelevant. Who rapped better in that fucking verse? Who did more? That's what it's about to me. And even with that, the majority of just hip-hop fans, fuck stands, hip-hop fans, feel like Eminem won that, right? Okay, so features. Jay, Big, Pac, Nas, Jada, Busta, Black Thought, Cypress Hill, Exhibit, Wayne, T.I., Red, Meth, 50, The Game, Lloyd Banks, Royce da 5'9", Joe Budden, King Crook, Joel Ortiz, Yellow Wolf, Kanye, Drake, Nicki Minaj, Remy Ma, Fat Joe, Big Sean, Joyner Lucas, Logic, Kid Cudi, and then these rappers are definitely not in his fucking league, but I'm just showing that Eminem is still rapping with the newbies. Even though B.O.B. is nice, but B.O.B., Eminem Wise, B.O.B., of course. Corday, Polo G, Griselda, Conway, Benny the Butch, come on, man. And that's not even everybody. Pretty much summarized the meat and potatoes of it. Bruh, Eminem rapped with all these motherfuckers, dog. Either won or it was debatable. Bruh, that is a tool in that motherfucker's toolbox. Who else out here can say that, bruh? I'm not gonna run through no records. That says it all. That says it all, man. And that could be a transition into the next tool in his toolbox. Diss records, rap beef, bruh. Who has single-handedly demolished more careers than Eminem? Has Eminem ever lost any type of fucking back and forth between any artists, bro? And is anybody going to go where Eminem's going to go with these diss records? Diss records is one tool in his toolbox, but the shit that Eminem will give you in diss records are other tools in his toolbox. You're not going to go where he's going to go. He will go where no other man will go with this diss record shit, bro. Tool in his toolbox, man. So motherfucker's scared to go at him. Because that white boy is crazy. Tool in his toolbox. Motherfuckers is scared of him, man. So let's do the diss record shit.